time for early Valentine's Day, I should say. Our theme tonight is love in all of its many forms. Romantic, familial, fraternal, friendship, perhaps even the love of a stranger. Someone you don't even know, and yet you can love them. And love them for who they are. I encourage you to follow along in your program. There are texts and translations.
Maybe you can't stand the way that they chew, or the way that they won't get their butt in the car when you need them to be in the car. The words printed in your program translate to, "We always squabble, we always fight. Is this love? Since we got married, we spent all our money. We squandered everything, for heaven's sake." Please enjoy this humorous depiction of a bickering married couple. Allie Wade will be our soloist.
Acknowledge familiar with Eric Whitaker's music. He is quite well, quite, let me start over. He is one of the most well-known living composers that writes in the medium either for a choir and or a wind band also. He also is very well known the world over for his lovely locks of hair. And if you know, you know. And in all seriousness, his music is known, generally speaking, for having this lush, thick, clashing harmonies that just never seem to give, and there's the chord moves from this one to the next, and there's just new dissonances, and it's always clustery and shimmering and beautiful. That's his trademark. And if you like that, that's wonderful. This is not that. There's a little bit of that. But this music was actually conceived in the 90s. That's, for those of you, that's the 1990s. Some of you who are counting. And it was written, actually the poetry was written by Hyda Lippmann, who's Eric Whitaker's fiance and became his first wife. Hyda Lippmann was an Israeli-American, and these are original love poems that were written between the two of them, and he actually wrote it for her. She was a concert operatic soprano. They were originally written to be songs for a soloist, and then people liked it so much, someone said, "Hey Eric, would you write these again for choir?" He said, "Sure." And then they said, "Would you write these again for choir and string quartet?" He said, "Sure." And so there's lots of versions out there. I encourage you to follow along in your programs to the translations. They are quite stunning. I want to give a special thanks to Dr. Brian Grazer, who helped us with our Hebrew diction. We're very fortunate to have that expertise, not just in Jonesboro, but right here in the Department of Music. And then